सदाशिवसमारं शंकराचार्यमध्यमास्मदाचार्यपर्यंतां वंदे गुरुपरंपरां श्रुतिस्मृतिपुराणानां आलयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शंकरं लोकशंकरं शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्रभाष्यकृतौ वंदे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेदविभागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्तदेहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः सहनावतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। यो ब्रह्माण्यधातुपुरो वेदाश्च प्रणोति तस्मै तगुम्भदेवात्मनित्यं प्रकाशं मुमुक्षुर्वै शरणमहं प्रपद्ये शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। आम्नायान्तिक संसिद्धमादिमध्यान्तवर्जितम् आनन्दघनमापूर्णम् आत्मज्योतिरुपास्महे। भोक्त्रापत्ते अधिकरण इज ओवर विद दैट। सो द सिक्स्थ अधिकरण begins with the 14th sutra, Arambhanadhikaranam. This adhikarana is introduced by the vritti by saying purvam. Just give me a moment, please. So purvam parinamavadam alambya apatatah syal lokavaditi samadhanam abhitam. So what was done is that the Sankhyavada is closest in the sense it is the Mukhya Purvapakshi. So considering their Parinamavada, while refuting the Parinamavada in the context apatata, so you have Parinamavada which has been established by Sankhyas, and while refuting that you build over that, show the flaws and then introduce something else which is the Siddhanta. So you don't agree with the Parinamavada, and what has been said Syad Lokavat in the earlier Syad Lokavat, sorry, here. सो भोक्त्रापत्तेर अविभागश्चेत् स्यात् लोकवत्। सो इन दि लोका यू सी दि मृत क्ले एक्चुअली गेटिंग ट्रांसफॉर्म्ड इनटू घटकुंभ इत्यादि। सो ऑल्दो देर इज अ परिणाम, सो यू टेक दैट परिणामवाद। सी घट मृत घट इज एन एग्जाम्पल फॉर परिणामवाद, because no one can prove the vivarta there to the Purvapakshi. Siddhanti can show that vivarta in the sense that the mrut has never changed from mrut, the clay still remains clay within the pot also, so that is the vivarta there. So real parinama example is not mrudghata, but the Purvapakshi can also argue that the shape has changed, everything has changed, therefore clay is no longer clay, it is pot. But the mukhya udharana for parinamavada proper is the milk turning into curd. So the milk curdling does not have milk anymore. So the, you cannot claim, as a vivartavadi, you cannot claim that the milk is still milk within the curd. The properties are different, characteristics are completely different. Why that? Even as per Ayurveda, curd being converted into buttermilk is also different, because curd is supposed to be ushna, whereas buttermilk has cooling, is shita. So exactly opposite characteristics. So you cannot claim that curd still remains curd while being buttermilk, transformed into buttermilk. But definitely we cannot claim that milk has still remained milk while it has curdled. Otherwise we would use curd for tea, right? So that can be an argument. Thereby, Parinamavada has been the basis of discussion so far, more or less. There has been Vivartavada shown, but then mostly the basis of argument was considering Parinamavada of Sankhyas. So Purvam Brahmani, Purvam Parinamavadam Alambya Apatataha Syallokavad Iti Samadhanam Abhitam. So even if you take Parinamavada, then Apatata means in the context something has come up. This is not the main perspective of the Siddhanti. So because you are dealing with Parinamavada, there also we can show that although the clay has undergone Parinama and become a pot, still the mrityum is not compromised. While it has become ghata, it has become kumbha, it has become the lid, it has become a cup, all these clay products are different from each other. The karyas are different from each other, but they are not different from the karana. So the clay still remains clay even when being transformed into its karyas. So utility wise there is bheda in the karyas. Various karyas have different utilities, various products have different utilities, but still they do not cease to be clay. So the abhinnatvam with clay is not compromised. So syad lokavat iti samadhanam abhihitam. This was stated. Adhuna, now what has done is that the mukhya siddhanta is vivartavada. Brahma has never changed. Brahma has never changed. That's why it is said kalpita bheda sattvat pratyaksha virodaha na iti siddham. There is a kalpita bheda in Brahma. There is no real bheda. There is no parinama. So adhuna vivartavadam ashritya paramam samadhanam abhidyate. Paramasiddhanta is vivartavada. It is not parinamavada. The parinama is in maya, prakriti, mula prakriti, because there cannot be karya from nirguna brahma. So nirguna brahma is not the karana, but without nirguna brahma there cannot be karanatvam in maya also. Therefore nirguna brahma along with maya not getting affected but somehow influencing maya to have parinama, and nirguna brahma itself remaining vivarta, untransformed, unchanged, is the parama siddhanta. So vivarta vadam ashritya paramam samadhanam abhijyate iti eka phalakatva sangatya idamaha. So the syal lokavat was an example given, and thereby the phala is what? Pratyaksha virodha nasti iti siddham. So the same phala applies here also, and thereby the next adhikarana gives shruti as pramana, arambhana adhikaranam. So arambhavada is actually kanabhaksha paksha. Kanadanam or kanada, those who follow the tarkikas or the tarkikas pakshas, is arambhavada. And then the Bauddhas, they talk about shunyavada or some sangata. So sangatavadaha bhadanta pakshaha. Sankhyas we know, parinamavadaha sankhya paksha. And what is the final paksha really? Vedanta paksha. Vivartavadaha vedanta paksha. So that is shloka to that effect. Vivartavada is vedanta paksha, that is being talked about, and then arambhana adhikarana shows that the it is not arambhavada, but arambhana adhikarana shows that shruti says that all of this, the arambha, there is no real arambha, meaning parinama is not there. And if parinama is not there, then something which is not existent is created as per Nayayikas. That is also not right. Why? Because द आरंभ इन श्रुति इज वाचारंभण. द आरंभ इज आलंबन. इट इज बेस्ड ऑन शब्द. इट इज बेस्ड ऑन नाम. दैट द रूप भेद इज सॉट आफ्टर बाय द अदर्स बट देर इज रियली नो भेद एट ऑल बिकॉज नाम एंड रूप आर बोथ मिथ्या. द डिफरेंस इन नाम causes difference in rupa while both remaining mithya and therefore there is no change in the karana at all. So that is shown in this adhikarana. The first sutra there, the 14th sutra is tadananyatvam arambhana shabdadibhyah. Tadananyatvam arambhana shabdadibhyah. So the sutra says tat tadananyatvam. So tat there is in the meaning of tasmat ananyatvam. Tasmat kasmat, tasmat karanat brahmanah. So from the karana brahma, the karya is non-different. Why so? Meaning there is no change in the karana and karya is mere appearance. So if you look at this tat, that can be a separate shabda in the meaning of tasmat. So tat is an avyaya in the meaning of panchami. Tasmat ananyatvam, non-difference. Why? So karyasya tad ananyatvam, tasmat karanat karyasya ananyatvam. Kutaha, the hetu is given as arambhana shabdadibhyaha, hetubhyaha, due to the आरंभण वाचारंभण इत्यादि शब्दास इन दी श्रुति. सो शब्द प्रमाण इज देर, देर फोर कार्य इज नॉट सेपरेट फ्रॉम कारण. नीदर इज इट अ परिणाम नॉर इज इट फ्रेशली क्रिएटेड समथिंग. सो इट इज विवर्तवाद दैट इज एस्टैब्लिश्ड हियर एज इन कार्य इज नॉन सेपरेट फ्रॉम कारण. एंड वेन कैन इट बी नॉन सेपरेट फ्रॉम कारण? ओनली वेन इट इज विवर्त, वेन दी Karana has never changed. It is a mere appearance. So that is established by the 14th sutra. Phalantu Purovat. So Samanvaya Asiddhi as per Purvapakshi and Samanvaya Siddhi as per Siddhanti. So here he says, Advaita Brahma Vadi Samanvayaha Bheda Grahi Pratyakshena Virudhyate Navayati Sandehe. The same objection which was raised in the earlier Adhikarana as to Pratyaksha Virodha is there. But that Pratyaksha Virodha was refuted by taking the Mridghata example and basing it on Parinamavada. Sankhya as a Purvapakshi raised a question. So even taking his own Parinamavada, it can be shown that there is a possibility of Karana and karya abhinnatvam, although there is difference between various karyas of the same karana. So advaita brahmavadi samanvayah, advaita brahmavadinam yah samanvaya brahmani samanvaya uktaha saha samanvaya virudhyate nava kena bhedagrahi pratyakshina. So the pratyaksha which is bhedagrahi, bhedasya bhedanam va ग्राही ग्राहक यह प्रत्यक्ष कर्मधारय देर. सो तेन प्रत्यक्षेण अद्वैत ब्रह्मवादिभि यह समन्वय उक्त सह समन्वय विरुध्यते वा न वा. इज देर विरोध ऑफ द प्रत्यक्ष? विच प्रत्यक्ष? दैट प्रत्यक्ष विच कीप्स ऑन सीइंग ग्रास्पिंग थ्रू ऑल द सेंस ऑर्गन्स ओनली multiplicity. Bheda is grasped all over with any sense organ. You can touch a pot and a cloth, you see difference. So it need not be only the indriya, chakshurindriya, not only through the vision but also through hearing there is bheda, through touching sparsha there is bheda. So with all sense organs you just cognize bheda. So that pratyaksha shows bheda, whereas advaita brahmavadi Brahma is Advaita, Advitiya Brahma, and that is the Vada. Vadha Advaita, Advaitam Brahma. Iti Yaha Vadaha, Saha Vadaha Asya Asti, or Esham Asti Iti Advaita Brahma Vadinaha. So we claim that Brahma is Advitiya. And how is it known? It is known through the Veda Vakyas aplenty, meaning not one or two, all the Veda Vakyas are committed to reveal only Advaita Brahma. Therefore, there is nothing other than Brahma, and that kind of a samanvaya of all Veda Vakyas in Brahma is refuted or countered, opposed by Veda Grahi Pratyaksha. Or is there no such virodha? When there is such shanka, sandeha, then viruddhyate iti purva paksha. Definitely pratyaksha is jeshta pramana for many darshanas, although they may not show astika darshanas also, and thereby they say there is virodha. Siddhantastu Vedanti says no, there is no virodha. Like earlier we have established, but we will show you through Shruti also now. Vivartavada is established, and therefore the pratyaksha bheda cannot, or bheda pratyaksha, either way. Karmadharya, therefore, you can swap it also, but grahi shabda not being there, you should say bheda pratyaksha. Bhedasya pratyaksha, bheda pratyaksha, it will become shashti. So, bhedasya pratyaksha tena virodha nasti. Why? Because the Siddhanti says that tasmat karanat brahmanah karyasya jagata ananyatvam. There is ananyatvam. Ananyatvam is shown by Shruti. Shruti says that there is no difference of karya from the karana. And karana is Brahma. So, tasmat karanat brahmanah. This is panchami. To show that the origin in Brahma is there for all karyas, but the karyas do not differ while being karyas also. While being created or manifest, and in the sthiti avastha also, and definitely in the laya avastha, there is no question at all. So in all the three, srishti, sthiti, laya, the karya is never separate from karana. So karyasya jagataha ananyatvam pratak sattarahityam. What is that ananyatvam? Oh, there is no oneness in sthiti. There is no oneness in such a manner that there is no difference. There is a difference. What kind of a difference is there? The difference is for utility. So, karyas have Vedas, because otherwise there cannot be samsaranam, prapancha. There cannot be difference between the difference between karyas not being there. There cannot be any utility. So, karyas differ from each other, which has been said, and that is the reason that the Veda Pratyaksha becomes the Hetu for opposing Advaita. So, the Veda Pratyaksha is valid. We do not disagree with Veda Pratyaksha. Veda Grahi Pratyaksha is definitely there, but that does not change the Ananyatvam and Vivartatvam of Brahma as Karana. That is what we have to show. So, we cannot say Veda is not there. In samsara, definitely, samsara avastha bheda is definitely there. That bheda is mithya bheda. Therefore, it cannot compromise the satya abhinnatvam. So, what is ananyatvam? Non-difference is prithak satta rahityam. There is no different satta. The satta is dependent satta. The jagat satta is dependent satta. The bheda which is seen in the prapancha, among the karyas are different from each other, but they do not have their own satta. The satta is Brahma satta, Karana satta. So, not having separate satta is ananyatvam. Kutaha, how do you say so? What is the pramana for that? Arambhana shabda adibhyaha, says the sutra, which means what? Vacharambhanam, arambhana is vacharambhanam. Vikaro namadheyam, mrittike ityeva satyam, says the Chandogya mantra. Then अवितदात्म्यम इदगुम सर्वम तत्सत्यम सात्मा तत्त्वमसि श्वेत केतु इत्यादि मंत्र इन छांदोग्य षष्ठो अध्याय अगेन देन ब्रह्मैवेदं सर्वम इत्यादि शब्देभ्यः सो देयर आर मेनी सच श्रुति वाक्यास विच शो अनन्यत्व ऑफ कार्य फ्रॉम कारण ब्रह्म. सो वाचारंभण इज वाक् आलंबनम यस्य विकारस्य बहुरी वाक् आरंभण विच इज आलंबन बेसिस फॉर प्रोडक्शन. सो व्हाट इज इट दैट कॉज दैट विकार. सो वाक् आरंभण यस्य विकारस्य सह विकार वाचारंभण विकार. कैन बी एक्चुअली विकार विकार इज दी अन्य पद बट व्हाट हैज बीन सेड इज दैट दिस नामधेयम. सो विकार गोज विथ नामधेयम विकार नामधेयम मृत्तिका इत्येव सत्यम. सो व्हाट इज विकार इज नामधेय. वाय इज विकार नामधेयम बिकॉज विकार इज वाचारंभण. दी विकार मीन्स कार्य. दी कार्य इज ओनली हैविंग अ सेपरेट नेम हैविंग अटर्ड मृत विच इज कारण. लेट से यू नो दैट इट इज मृत. एवरी वन नोज दैट क्ले एग्जिस्ट दैट्स ऑल मृत. सो मृत हैज सत्ता. मृत इज देर. क्ले इज देर. नाउ हैविंग नोन दिस मृत एज बीइंग देर एज वन विदाउट एनीथिंग एल्स नो कार्यज आर देर देन something is created. The clay undergoes some mixing up, some shaping up, etc. The kulala is doing something and then finally the clay itself is shaped into a different form. It is all clay. Okay, it is burnt. Even after being burnt and hardened, it is still clay. Now what happens is that this kulala gives it a name. He says that this vikara, this karya of mrut is what? Now I'll call it as ghataha. Assume this. Suppose such a thing happened. Unless you name it as ghata, how will you differentiate? We have seen earlier as even among twins, Siamese twins, so they look alike. How do the parents differentiate between the twins? For all practical purposes, if you did not know that your neighbor has twins and you see one kid at a time, a different kid every time you look at outside your balcony, whatever, and you see, you think that it is the same kid. You cannot make out a difference. Initially, the parents also cannot make out a difference. So, difference between the twins, and they name them separately. They name, give them different names. One is Rama, the other one is Shyama. So, this name has created a difference, or the name makes you identify the difference also. So that is just an example to show that, of course, twins are two different entities, but just to drive home the point as to nama is used to create the bheda or identify the bheda which is existent. Here what is said in the shruti is that the vikara, which is karya of the karana, that karana itself is appearing as karya. So the mrut has been shaped up. It is still mrut. When did it become different from mrut? Only when it was given a name as ghata. Otherwise you cannot transact. You will have to say shape the mrut in this kind of a manner and then I will buy that. For easy transaction you have to give it a name. As soon as you have given it a name as ghata, it is different from mrut. Why? Because mrut is a separate word, ghata is a separate word, and thereby vacharambhana, vikara is that which has vak as its arambhana, beginning also, source also, and alambana also, the adhisthana. The vikara rests on the, meaning its satta rests on the vak itself. Speech, it has been created with a word. So vacharambhana vikara namadhyam, it is nothing. Namadhyam is nama matram, nothing else. It is just a nama. Ghata is just a nama. It is all mrut. Otherwise it is all mrut. therefore what is satyam since vikara satta is not karana satta bhinna satta therefore what mrittika ityeva satyam what is satya if you inquire ghata satta if you inquire into satta satyam if you inquire into then it is all ghata satta therefore ghata satta is all mrut satta therefore mrittika ityeva satyam even while you are looking and using the mrut ghata that ghata is nothing but mrut its satta is mrut satta every characteristic of the ghata is really the characteristic of mrut the shape it is the shape of the mrut the weight is the weight of the clay if you use other sense organs you touch tap it is all clay that is why how do you identify that the pot is a clay pot you can tap you feel the clay you don't feel anything else you don't feel metal there you feel clay therefore by touch also by texture also you know that it is clay so the texture of the pot is also the texture of clay the taste is of clay the smell is of clay everything is nothing but clay therefore it is non different from karana mrut so mrittika ityeva satyam there is no prithak satta then aitadatmyam idam sarvam tat satyam sa atma and all of this atma it is all nothing but atma brahmatma karana karya is nothing but by swarupa aitadatmyam this by swarupa it is all esha atma and then bhava il got aitadatmyam it is all by swarupa brahmatma for what each and everything that you look at in the prapancha so idam sarvam jagat aitadatmyam in swarupa if you look at it meaning what when you inquire into the way you inquire into ghata if you inquire into sarvam each and every padartha in the prapancha then you will see there is no pratak satta and what is that which tells you that there is no pratak satta what is this mrittika ityeva satyam you go to its karana of any karya then you go to the karana of that karya also because mrut is also karya you keep on going back you will land on something which does not have karana and you don't have to go thus far also this is all you know manana just hypothesis or an imagination that you have actually done that it is all analysis chintana but you can directly know because brahma is what is revealed by shruti as parama karana karana rahita karana that karana rahita karana happens to be you brahmatma brahma is atma jivatma therefore you are the one who is looking at this sarva prapancha idam sarvam so you look at anything in the prapancha it does not have pratak satta because as long as you are looking at it so long it is having satta you look at ghatapatadi prapancha you say that it is there why do you say that it is existent even a charvaka would say it is there because I see it nobody can deny it to you because you are seeing it I feel it pratyaksha for you so you take the same pratyaksha that the purvapakshi is claiming as basis for bheda so bhedagrahi pratyakshena his hetu is what bhedagrahi pratyakshatvat is itself a hetu bhedagrahi pratyakshatvat advaita brahma vadi samanvayah viruddhyate kena viruddhyate bhedagai pratyakshena hetunayo viruddhyate the hetu itself is opposing your samanvaya in advaita so you take that very hetu you say bhedagai grahi pratyaksha I agree with now you take that bhedagrahi pratyaksha ghata is different pata is different what am I saying says the siddhanti this ghata and pata both are non different from their parama karana brahma and what do we say by that by ananyatvam we have said that prithak satya rahityam prithak satta rahityam the ghata does not have brahma bhinna satta and pata also does not have brahma bhinna satta, and that brahma is who I am, that brahma. So you take the same bhedagrahi pratyaksha, we say ghata and pata are non different from brahma even while being different from each other. So ghata is different, pata is different, but ghata is non different from brahma satta, meaning ghata satta is non different from brahma satta, pata satta is non different from brahma satta. Which is that satta? Mat satta, mama satta, my satta. I am seeing this ghata and pata as different through my pratyaksha pramana, my chakshurindriya, which happens to be pratyaksha to me. Which the ghata pata, which happens to be pratyaksha for me, is through chakshurindriya. So chakshurindriya or any other indriya also, but pratyaksha. Pratyaksha indriya gochara ghata pata bheda is there, but I am asking you not to focus on the ghata pata bheda. My focus is on satta. I see the ghata when I see the ghata. I see the pata when I see the pata. When I do not see, then ghata does not have satta, pata also does not have satta. The Purva Pakshi would say that just because you don't see, the ghata pata won't vanish. They are still there. They are there from somebody else's perspective. Okay. I have two arguments now. Two responses to that argument rather. I can say that who is seeing it? Say Devadatta is seeing it. Devadatta is seeing it when I do not see it. Then he sees Ghatasatta, Patasatta. Then that Ghatasatta and Patasatta is lent by Devadatta's Brahmatma Swarupa. Ghata does not have its own Satta. Pata does not have its own Satta. So if Devadatta is seeing it, somebody is seeing it. Without somebody seeing, there is no Satta. So that person who is cognizing, seeing, touching, tasting, whatever it is, through that very kriya, the swarupa of that entity who is the cognizer has lent the satta to the karma, to the vishaya, to prapancha. That is one response. The other response is that I can say that who is seeing it? You are saying that somebody else saw. That you who is saying it is also gaining the satta from me. Only when I wake up, you can make a claim and say that that ghatapata was still existent. It didn't vanish when you slept. So when I slept, that person who claims the ghatapata to be there, that person himself is not there, let alone the ghatapata. So on my waking up also, the ghatapata which gets existence due to my cognizing it, if it is refuted by this another person who says that it was there even when you slept, that person himself wasn't existent. So who gave him satta to cognize the ghatapata? Nobody gave him satta, let alone ghatapata getting satta from him or from me. I wasn't there, I was asleep, so I was not cognizing it. I did not give the satta to ghatapata to exist, nor did this other person give any satta, because he himself didn't get satta from me to exist. His body, mind, sense complex, that is. So, Ekajivavadi would say that you yourself are not there. You weren't there when I was asleep. So, now that you are claiming you yourself are getting the satta from me, just like the ghatapata. So, these are two responses possible to such a Purva Paksha. However, Bhedagrahi Pratyaksha itself is being used to say that we agree with the bheda in the karyas, but the satta of the bhinna karyas is not their own satta. It is the satta of Brahma, and that Brahma is me. So the Shruti Vakya culminates in Aikya. Taking that culmination, I can say that Brahma satta is Atma satta, and therefore the Prithak satta rahityam of Ghatapatadi prapancha is ananyatvam from Brahma, which is ananyatvam from me. So I lend it satta. I lend this ghatapatadi prapancha satta. So that is Aitad Atmyam Idagum Sarvam. And what is that finally? That Atma is Satyam. Tat Satyam Sa Atma. And then the Shruti goes on to say what? Tattvamasi Shvetaketu. That you are. Sa Atma. So whoever says Atma is my real Swarupa, that is Brahma Swarupa. Sat Brahma. And then another Shruti says Brahma Evidam Sarvam. Brahma Evidam Sarvam. All this is nothing but Brahma. Meaning Sarvam Nasti. Brahma Evasti. Nasti means what? Sarva Prapancha does not have its own Satta. So it is Bada Samanadi Karanyam. Sarvam Nasti. Because what? Swarupena Sarvam Nasti. By Swaswarupa Sarvam Nasti, Ghatapata as Ghatapata, having their own Satta, they do not exist. But having Brahma Satta, Atma Satta, they exist. So their existence is existence borrowed from Brahma, therefore Sarvam Nasti, Brahma Evaidam, Sarvam means Brahma Eva Asti. Sarvarupena Bhati, Brahma Eva Bhati, Sarvesham Satta, Brahma Satta Eva. Natu bhinna satta, natu pratak satta, therefore what sarvam nasti, swasatta rupena sarvam nasti, brahma eva asti, idam sarvam nasti, that is bada samanadikran, ityadi shabdebhya. So due to these shabda pramanas, shruti pramanas, there is aikya which is not compromised, samanvaya in advaita brahma is not compromised by pratyaksha which shows bheda. Brahma vyatirekena karyasya abhave anumanam aha. Further what? There is an anumana. Pratyaksha virodha is not acceptable. Using the same pratyaksha we can show you that pratak satya rahityam makes the samanvaya still stand uncompromised. And karya not being there other than Brahma. Meaning Karya Satta is not different from Brahma Satta, therefore Brahma Vyatirekena Karyasya Abhave Anumanamaha. It has been stated earlier, there is inference also, Anumana is also possible to show that, because Anumana is not Shushka Tarka or Kevala Tarka, the way the Purvapakshi used. We are showing Tarka based on Shruti, because Shruti has already been given in the 14th Sutra. Now the 15th Sutra uses Anumana and shows. भावे च उपलब्धे हे भावे च उपलब्धे हे सो भाव इज प्रेजेंस सत्ता सत्वे सत्वम सो सत्ता ऑफ द कार्य इज सत्ता ऑफ द कारण भावे च उपलब्धे हे भावे सति एव उपलब्धि भवति कार्यस्य उपलब्धि सो कार्यस्य उपलब्धेः बिकॉज कार्य उपलब्धि इज देयर ओनली व्हेन कारण इज देयर विदाउट द कारण कार्य उपलब्धि कैन नॉट बी देयर देयरफॉर कार्य हैज डिपेंडेंसी ऑन कारण बिकॉज व्याप्ति इज देयर यत्र यत्र कारण भावः तत्र तत्र कार्योपलब्धि और रादर सॉरी यत्र यत्र कार्योपलब्धि तत्र तत्र कारण भावः यत्र यत्र कारण अभावः तत्र तत्र कार्योपलब्धि नास्ति दैट इज द व्याप्ति शोन हियर एंड देयरफॉर दिस इज एन अनुमान सो कारण भावे सति च कार्याणां कार्यस्य वा उपलब्धिः भवति तस्मात् हेतोः उपलब्धि तस्याः हेतुः अदरवाइज सो उपलब्धि बीइंग स्त्रीलिंग स्त्रीलिंग इफ यू उपलब्धि इफ इट इज की प्रत्यांत इट वुड बी इट इज तीन प्रत्यांत उपलब्धि सो देयर बाय स्त्रीलिंग सो एनीवे हेतु पंचमी सो भावे च उपलब्धे हे बिकॉज देयर इज उपलब्धि ऑफ कार्य ओनली व्हेन कारण भाव इज देयर ओनली व्हेन कारण भाव इज देयर देयरफॉर व्हाट Therefore, there is no possibility of samanvaya being compromised in Brahma, because Brahma is the Paramakarana, and only when Brahma is there, the entire prapancha is there. When the prapancha is cognized, Brahma is definitely there. That Brahma is the cognizer himself, Swarupa of the cognizer, that we saw in the 14th Sutra. And when the cognizer is not there, how can there be any karya? There is no karya without Brahma. And thereby, bhave chopalabdehe. Karanasya brahmanaha bhave sattve. Only when, sati saptami, only when karana brahma is there, satta is there, brahma satta is there, then alone karyasya upalabdhi. And thereby, karyasya upalabdehe heto ho, heto panchami. Karyasya upalabdhi, karya upalabdhi, karya being available for any transaction only when karana is there. Look at the example. He says, mridi satyam ghatasya iva. So only when mrit is there, ghata karya is possible. You cannot create ghata without mrit. Clay pot cannot be created without the clay. So only when clay is there, the karya is possible. Then when the ghata is created, after creation, can I take away the mrit and say, okay, use the ghata? Cannot. Pooja Swamiji jokingly used to say that at one jeweler's shop inauguration, he was invited, and then he was very happy that Pooja Swamiji went there. So the jeweler said, look at this shop of mine, pick anything that you want. I would like to give that as dana. Please pick anything that you want. So he asked Pooja Swamiji to take anything from the shop full of gold. And Pooja Swamiji said, okay, I do not want anything else, just give me gold. What will remain in the shop? If you take away just gold from all the gold ornaments, there is no ornament left. So ghatasya iva, mridi satyam ghatasya iva, ghatasya upalabdhi is possible only when mrit is there. You take away mrit, even after creating ghata, you say, okay, I want my mrit. Nothing will remain. So, nahi mrit vyatirekena ghato nama kaschid upalabhyate. There is no ghata possible to be cognized if the karana mrit is taken away. You take away the clay, there is nothing called as pot. There will be no possibility for the pot to exist. No ornaments can exist if you take the gold away. The gold ornaments cannot exist. Ataha karana vyatirena karyam nasti ityartha. So using the anumana, even the tarkika's anumana will fail there, because that anumana will lead to samanvaya in Brahma, not samanvaya virodha. So anumana also cannot, pratyaksha virodha is not there, anumana virodha is also not there, because anumana is establishing samanvaya really, as to karya being abhinna from karana. Then the next sutra is introduced by saying, karana vyatirikena karasya abhave shrutarthapatti pramanantaram ah. So arthapatti pramana, shrutarthapatti pramana, the shruti gives a pramana which is arthapatti pramana, that is shrutarthapatti pramana. Anyatha anupapatti is used for arthapatti, otherwise not possible. What is that showing? That is showing karya cannot be there without karana. Sattva chavarasya. So the sutra, 16th sutra says avarasya, sattvat cha avarasya. Avara is karya. The avara, which is karya, karyasya sattvat, avarasya sattvat cha, karyasya sattvat cha. What is that? Shrutarthapatti. So it says, it will be clear in the vritti. Avarasya karyasya utpattehe prak karana ananyatvena sattvat. So sattvat, avarasya karyasya sattvat means what? Utpatte prak sattvat. Because the karya is there in the karana. Karya is there in the Karana even before the Karya is created. If you want to create gold bangle, you cannot pick up silver or clay. You have to pick up gold. So the bangle is hidden in the gold. A better example, if you look at it, easier, better in the sense, easier example to understand is that the sculptor, when he creates something out of stone, let's say a huge idol has to be created. Look at this Ayodhya, Rama Mandira, the Rama has to be carved out of what? The Murti of Rama has to be carved out of stone. So if it's a particular stone which is being brought from Nepal, let's say. So that huge stone has Rama's Murti hidden within. That is seen only by the sculptor. So he has a vision how I can carve the Rama Murti, the form of Rama from this stone. Why? Because it is there within. You cannot pick up a small stone and say that I'll carve out a huge Rama out of it, because the large, huge Rama's Murti is not hidden in the small stone. In the huge stone structure, the Murti is hidden. In fact, many Murtis are hidden. You can carve out any Murti based on what you see there. So your sight of that particular Karya will make it a reality, you as a sculptor. The sculptor looking at the stone will say, oh, I see, I can carve this out. I can carve this particular image out of this particular idol out of this stone. Why? Because he can see that within. He has that vision that it is there, that very kind of a shape is brought out by him by sculpting out, by removing the other things out of the stone. So the Karya is hidden in that stone. The Karya Murti is hidden in that very Karana stone. Similarly, in each and every Karya, each and every Karana, the Karya is hidden. Every Karya comes out of that specific Karana alone. You cannot bring it out of anything else. Because if it is freshly created, which is not there, meaning the Karya is not there in the Karana, then you can use any Karana and bring out. Why do you need only that Karana? You can use hundreds of Karanas. Let's say you want to make curd, and you say curd is not hidden in the milk. Then I'll give you anything that you want except milk. You can use anything. I'll give you gold also if you want, but you have to make curd out of it. Can you make it? No one can make it. Only that specific Samagri is needed. Why? Because only in that specific Samagri Karana, the Karya is hidden. It is very much there. If I give you the entire world other than milk, you cannot make curd out of it, because the curd is hidden only in the its Karana milk. So that is said here as to Karyasya Utpatte Prak, Avarasya Karyasya Utpatte Prak, Avara is Karya. Before the creation of the Karya, Karana Ananyatvena Sattva, the Karya was present in the form of Karana itself. So where is the curd? The curd is there in the form of milk, in the milk itself. Where is the idol? The idol is in the stone, which is its Karana, in the form of the, in the form of, it is not having the idol's form. It is not having the form of the idol. It is there in the form of the Karana stone. So therefore, Sattvat is Hetu. Karyasya Karana Rupena Sattvat. Kada Utpatte Prak, Karya Utpatte Prak. Therefore, that Shruti says Brahmavaidam Agrasit Ityadu Sattva Shravana Utpatyanantaram Api Ananyatvam Siddham Ityartaha. So, if the Karya was there in the Karana even before the Karya was created, then after the Karya being created, how can it be different from the Karana? It will be non-different from the Karana even after creation. So Brahmava idam agra asit, idam agre srishtehe prak, idam jagat Brahma vai asit. Indeed, it was all in the form of Brahma. There was no nama rupa bheda of this jagat before creation. It was all in the form of Brahma. Form of Brahma means Brahma rupa. It was the way Brahma is, it was always like that. Even now it is like that. Additionally, what do you have Nama Rupa to transact. So only for transaction purpose you have Vacharambana, Namadheya and Rupa also. Thereby you can transact after Srishti. Before Srishti there was no transaction possible, but it does not mean that Prapancha was not there. It was not there in the form of Prapancha, but Prapancha was there in the form of Brahma. It continues to be in the form of Brahma even now, meaning Satta is Brahma Satta. Only Nama Rupa is causing this Bhedagrahi Pratyaksha. That does not take away the Brahmatva Karanatva of Karya. Ityadu Sattva Shravanat. There you hear this Sattva of Brahma, Sattva of Karya in the form of Brahma. Utpatti Anantaramapi Ananyatvam Siddham. Therefore, even after Utpatti, during the Siddhi Avastha also, Karya is non-different from Karana. Pragutpattehe Karanatmana Karyasattvam Akshipya Samadatte. Now, just give me one, there is some discussion there, but anyway, let me just explain this Arthapatti Pramana itself. As I said, you cannot pick up any other Karya, you cannot pick up any other Karana and bring out Karya. So, each Karya needs a particular Karana. Therefore, it has to be existent in the earlier Swarupa Karana. And after creation also, it will remain in the, remain Abhinna from Karana. Because its Satta is Karana Satta. This much we have seen, but why is it Arthapatti here? If you look at it, Arthapatti is otherwise not possible. It is using Anyatha Anupapatti. Meaning, you take any other Karana, you will not get that specific Karya. It has to be only the Karana of that Karya alone will give you that Karya. No other Karana will give. Therefore, what? Anyatha Anupapatti. Since only this particular Karana can give me this particular Karya, this Karya has to be existent in the Karana, otherwise not possible. So that is the Arthapatti there. The next sutra, Pragutpattehe Karanatmana Karyasya Sattvam Akshipya Samadatte. So there is a, this will be explained, I mean what I said here as Arthapatti will be explained later in some other sutra. Vritti. So Pragutpattehe Karanatmana Karyasya Sattvam Akshipya Samadatte. There is an akshepa as to Karya being there in the form of Karana before the creation of that Karya, and thereby Samadhanam is given. Asad Vyapadeshan Neti Chenna Dharmantarena Vakya Sheshat. Asad Vyapadeshan Na Iti Chet Na Dharmantarena Vakya Sheshat. So this is something that we have seen earlier. As to the Asadva Idamagra Asit kind of a Shruti is also there. So all this was Asat. Shruti also says that it was all Sat, and another word is also used, Asat. So thereby the Shunyavadi says that it is all Asat. Before creation there was no Satta. Or the Purvapakshi Nayayika can also use this kind of a Shruti and say that there was no Karya in Karana. Why? Because there was Asat. The Karya was Asat before creation. So Shruti says, Asadva Idamagra Asit. So Asad Vyapadesha, there is a teaching of Asat also as Karana. Meaning all this Karya being Asat, meaning not being in Karana. So how do you claim that the Karya is in Karana by Arthapatti Pramana? The Shruti itself will supersede your Arthapatti Pramana, says the Purva Bhakshi. He says, Asad Vyapadeshat, Asadva Idamagra Asit Iti Asad Vyapadeshat. There is a teaching of Karya being Asad before creation. Idam Agre Srishte Pra Asadva Asit, Asadvai Asit, it was Asat. So there is a Shruti like that. So you need not quote only Brahmava Idamagra Asit, Asadva Idamagra Asit is also Shruti. So how will you explain your Karya being in the form of Karana, Sad Brahma, it was all Asat. So Tayyayika is saying that there is a real creation which is separate from the Karana. Karya is not Abhinna from कार्य कारण कार्य इज भिन्न फ्रॉम कारण दैट इज द रीजन वी हैव दीज सप्त पदार्थ वैशेषिका विल से और मेनी 16 पदार्थ फॉर तार्किका नैयायिका सो एटलीस्ट 7 पदार्थ आर देर एंड वी डिवाइड देम इवन फर्दर वी डिवाइड देम एज द्रव्य इत्यादि then we divide dravyas we divide gunas also so much division is there in not only in the karya but this categorization has atma also as one of the padarthas atma is a dravya dravya padartha so atma is bhinna from the other anatmas anatmas are bhinna from atma atma is bhinna from anatma and atma is bhinna from each and every anatma different kind of padarthas Therefore, there is no abhinnatvam from karana at all, and atma is not brahma for them. They say paramatma and atma are different. Therefore, all this will not fit in for the tarkika. So he says asadva idam agra asit shows that karya was not sat; it was asat in pre-creation avastha, meaning prak utpatti. उत्पत्ति है प्राक बिफोर द उत्पत्ति ऑफ दिस प्रपंच कार्य इट वॉज असत मीनिंग इट वॉज नॉट एग्जिस्टेंट इट इज अ रियल क्रिएशन सो असद व्यपदेशात दैट बिकम्स द हेतु असत बीइंग द टीचिंग ऑफ दिस कार्य बीइंग बिफोर क्रिएशन न सो व्हाट यू आर सेइंग एज टू कार्य being present in the form of karana before creation is not right na iti chet if this be the objection na is the response na why dharmantarena vakya sheshat dharmantarena vakya sheshat the vakya shesha you don't take only asadvaidam agrasit you take the entire context says the siddhanti you look at the context the shruti does start by asadvaidam agrasit then it explains that nama rupa wasn't there So asat does not show that the karya was asat, but karya nama rupa was not there, meaning avyakta it was. In the vyakta manifest form, the karya wasn't there. It was in the unmanifest form. So asat does not mean non-existent there. Asat dharmantarena. The karya dharma on creation is what nama rupas are the dharma, vyakta dharmas are there. But the nama rupa was unmanifest. It was all avyakta. That is the meaning of asat in the shruti as seen by vakya shesha, meaning the other vakyas in the same section clarify how to interpret asat shabda. Thereby asadva idam agra asid ityadina pragutpattehe asad vyapadeshat na karyasya karanatmana sattvam iti chet. So if there be an Akshepa, there be an objection as to Karya was not in the form of Karana as claimed by you in Sattva Chavarasya because the Shruti says that all this was non-existent, Asat in the beginning before creation. Then the response given is no, not so. Why? You have misinterpreted the meaning of Asat Shabda in the Shruti. Nahi. अत्यंत असत्वाभिप्रायेण अयम असत्व व्यपदेशादि असत्व व्यपदेश असद व्यपदेश इज डेफिनेटली देर इन दि श्रुति द टीचिंग ऑफ असत इज देर यूजिंग द वर्ड असत बट दैट असत शब्द इज नॉट मेंट इज नॉट मीनिंग अत्यंत असत अत्यंत असत्व अभिप्राय इज नॉट देर देर इज नो इंटेंशन ऑफ द श्रुति बाय यूजिंग द असत शब्द टू से दैट इट इज अत्यंत असत कार्य इज नॉट अत्यंत असत किंतु व्याकृतत्व रूप धर्मापेक्षया अव्याकृतत्वं धर्मांतरं तेन अयम असत्व व्यपदेश सो धर्मांतरण वाक्य शेष व्हाट इज धर्मांतर अन्य धर्म धर्मांतरम अनदर धर्म अनदर गुण अनदर क्वालिटी सो व्याकृतत्वं मीन्स मैनिफेस्टेड सो द मैनिफेस्टेड गुणास द मैनिफेस्टेशन इज द Dharma of the Nama Rupa manifestation is there in the and due to Nama Rupa you can cognize without the Nama Rupa you cannot cognize so all the gunas that you can cognize in the karya after creation, they cannot be cognized in the karana, karanavastha. So avyakritatvam is the dharmantaram. The current dharma that you see is manifest vyakruta dharmas, and dharmantara means another dharma other than this dharma is what? Unmanifested. So unmanifested state was the state of this karya before creation, and that is called by the word asat, that is meant by the word asat. Kintu vyakrutatva rupa dharma apeksha, compared to the vyakrutatva rupa dharma which is there in the present state of created state, avyakrutatvam is another dharma, dharmantaram, tena ayam asatva vyapadesha. Due to that avyakrutatvam being there, meaning the prapancha karya was unmanifest in the pre-creation state, therefore asat shabda has been used. Kutaha, why so? Vakya sheshat, because what follows is what? Tat sadasit. Shruti cannot say asadasit and then tat sadasit, they are contradictory. Directly contradiction can be seen, and when there is a direct contradiction in the same section of the Shruti, you have to reinterpret the words that you have understood. So it is not a contradiction. Shruti cannot have a contradiction. It is flawless. Therefore, you have to find flaws in your interpretation. So the direct contradiction is an apparent contradiction. When you reinterpret asat as what? Avyakrita, then tat sadasit and tat asadasit also will fit together, because sat is sadeva satyam, and then asat will be what? Different from sat, different from vyakruta, different from vyakruta being avyakruta. So avyakruta, avyakrutam va idamagra asit will be the meaning there of asat, va idamagra asit. And there tat sad asit, all this was that real tad brahma iti vakya shesha, that shows you that asat has to be reinterpreted. Ataha karanad ananyatvam karyasya siddham ityartha. Therefore there is no compromise of samanvaya, of karya being non-different from karana, and brahma is the tatpare vishaya of all shrutis. This is the 17th sutra. We will look at kincha 18th sutra in the next part. Amnayante samsiddham adhi madhyanta varjitam anandaghanam apurnam atmi jyoti rupasmehe. Namaste, dhanyavada.
Namaste.